the ball. I don't pass till I'm gone. I can laugh when I'm on. I'm not a prophet, I'm getting profits. This is that God shit. You wanna be flossing, then you gonna trip off your losses. Young bullshit. Spend a whole bag on my baby.
What's goody? What's poppin', y'all? It's your boy Shaq coming back to y'all with another video. So the K24 is all bolted in. It is on the transmission. It spins. So far, we don't know if it's spin the wheels when it's on power, when it's like the car's turned on. We haven't tested that yet. We're trying to get all this wiring done. You see, I have all the wiring done. Right now, I need a K20 crank position sensor. This one does not fit this harness because it needs a K20 sensor. So we have to deal with that. We have to cut all these ejector clips off and redo them for the ID1050s that we have. So that's another thing we have to get done. We have to shave the bracket right here a little bit because with the the forward facing S2000 intake, it sits, my throttle body sits right there. So we have to shave that down just a tad. And then we have the intake manifold from the S2000 all welded and cut because we have to cut off all this because we have the K-Tune water adapter. And then we have to cut and extend all of these for my throttle body because my throttle body does not sit in the stock location. It sits in the S2000 location. So my throttle body is going to be over here. So we have to get all that done. We also have to cut and trim this like hose that comes out of here. I don't know where it's at. I think I put it in the, yeah, it's right here. So we have to cut and trim this edge off of here so this can sit in there and it goes straight into my heater core. We have that also to do today. When I do all this stuff when I'm at work, so we have that to do. Put that down. But yeah, literally all this is literally ready to rock. We need hoses. We need hoses. My radiator. I have a radiator that goes in here so perfect that and both the hose is on the driver's side, so I could be able to hook it up here at the top and then hook it up right here at the bottom. So everything will be on the driver's side. I have 2 10-inch fans coming for it. We don't know if the 2 10-inch fans will fit this radiator because I bought the 10-inch fans with the old radiator setup that I had, and they fit perfect. But with the new radiator setup, I don't know if they'll fit. We might have to go down to 2 8-inch fans, but I might be able to keep 1 10-inch, 1 8-inch. We'll see how it goes once we get the radiator. Ooh, shoot. Once we get the radiator, we'll see how it goes. But the fuel pump still needs to be hooked up. That's almost done. I literally put the wire onto the K-Tune wiring harness. I put the wire on there, but I didn't wire it completely in. Still have to wire that in, but it looks like a mess under there because all these wires are loose, but I clean it up after I get everything running. I still don't have the Hondata in the car. It's still in the house. I was tuning it a little bit, trying to work my way around it. But that's almost done as well. This thing's almost ready to rock, guys. I have an alternator that comes Friday as well. I got the fans coming Saturday. Today is Thursday. Happy Thanksgiving to everybody. You know, my bad, I forgot all about that. You know, it's hard for me to celebrate it because I always end up working on that day. I work today from 3 to 11. I'll be able to make it after, you know, and get some food. But happy Thanksgiving to everybody else. To everybody that has to work on all the holidays, big shout out to y'all, military or not. Big shout out to everybody that has to work on the holidays. It sucks, but you know, somebody has to do it, and so happened that those people volunteered to do it. So big shout out to them. If you got a family member that has to work on Thanksgiving, Christmas, or anything, just go and give them a hug, man. Give them big praise, you know, because it's hard missing your family on the holidays, man. It really sucks. I don't have any family here in New Mexico. All my family's in California, so I made that sacrifice to not be with them, but it's for a cause. So big shout out to my family for dealing with me for that. But hey, man, we're almost done with this car. It'll be up here probably in the next week, so hopefully everything works right. We have a belt tensioner coming as well, so hopefully we can get all this stuff buttoned up and this will be done, man, because literally we're almost there. We're almost there. So we just need that alternator and we'll be done. So yeah, we got the fuel done. Oh, we do need a fuel regulator now. I just realized that for the fuel rail, there's a, on the S2000, there's a regulator that sends the fuel back on the return. I need that as well, so I'm gonna go buy that probably tomorrow. That way I can have that on the car as well. But everything literally is coming either Friday, Saturday, or Monday. I have everything, the rest of the stuff for the car is coming. All the stuff I need to turnkey the car, shall I say, is coming that day. Other than that, we're literally ready to rock on this car. Hopefully my battery isn't dead. Hopefully, because it has been sitting like on off the car for probably like 2 months. So hopefully the battery's not too dead. Hopefully I could just go charge it maybe. Hopefully the cells didn't just die. But yeah, so everything's ready to rock. I'm gonna bleed the clutch probably tomorrow. When I get the radiator, I'll bleed the clutch. I'll probably make a video of me bleeding the clutch. Like I said, it's a Clutch Masters push style throw out bearing. So we'll try to, it'll be my first time ever doing one of these. So we'll try to bleed the clutch. Camaro is still broken as usual. So that will be done next year. Like I said, and yeah, if you don't know what happened to the Camaro, go watch my last video. You'll see everything that happens to the Camaro. But this thing is ready to rock. All we have to do is button up everything, get hoses, all that other stuff. And then we'll be able to make power on this. So right now we're going to go NA. We're not going to do turbo. I have a turbo. I don't have a wastegate and a blow off valve. So I need to buy that stuff. I need a turbo manifold. And then we'll be able to boost this thing for right now. And we're going to need new spark plugs. I'm going to re-gap them. Get brand new spark plugs. Every time I throw a turbo in a car, I get brand new spark plugs. Start off fresh. But as you can see, we got the K-Tune harness running into the firewall like it's stock. This is for a OBD2 sensor. We don't have one right now, so I'm actually gonna leave that like that. I might zip tie it until we get one. I also, to figure out this like pitch mount, to figure that out, I actually bought, I don't know where they're at. I'm trying to show you what I bought. Actually, I have two extra ones. Let me show you. I actually bought two of these things right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put one up top and one at the bottom, and I'm gonna go get a threaded pipe, and we're gonna thread some pipe into that. We're gonna cut it, thread some pipe into this, and then put like two nuts on the end of it. That way it'll be adjustable, and I can have it adjustable and all that stuff like that. I thought about it after a guy told me about it. He was like, yeah, why don't you just use the bump steer mounts to try to use for that? And I was like, oh, that's a good idea. So we're gonna try that out, see if that works. Hopefully it works. That way we can, you know, be able to adjust it and all that other stuff. But other than that, man, we're literally ready to rock with this. So yeah, stay tuned with y'all, man. I'll give y'all more videos. I'm gonna upload a lot of videos here in the next 2 to 3 weeks. We're gonna be uploading a lot of videos. That way we can keep y'all, you know, up to date. So like, comment, subscribe. Tell a friend if you're new or if you're old. Just tell a friend. Help me out. I catch y'all. Peace.